The email tracking myth. Why you'll never reliably know if your message was read. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got a long time ago. In my business, it is critical that I know that emails I have sent were received and opened. The emails are time sensitive and contain deadline dates for the information requested. I have searched for things like emails opened and asked questions, but all that has been futile. I'm certain that I'm not the only person unable to find an answer to this problem. That is correct. That's because there is no answer to this problem. And you're, like I said, you're quite right. You're not the only person wishing otherwise. As a result, many, many companies offer so-called email tracking services claiming to do it. The problem? They overpromise and underdeliver. I want to explain why. I want to start by making something excruciatingly clear. There is no 100% reliable way to tell with certainty that an email you sent has or has not been received, opened, or read. None. If your business relies on that, then you need to find a different approach to communicating with your clientele. Now, I get a ton of pushback when I make those statements, but that's the way it is. No magic tool or technique is going to make it otherwise. There are a couple of reasons for this reality. You could choose one or the other depending on your level of cynicism. Number one, email is broken. I won't argue. Number two, your recipient's right to privacy trumps your need to know. Spam made everyone realize just how important privacy is. Spam is the reason email programs disable the methods that can track email reception. So you can blame spam, if you like, for making this impossible. Whether that's part of email is broken or right to privacy, it is what it is. And at the risk of repeating myself, you cannot track with certainty whether a specific email has been opened or read. Period. Now, let's take a look at some of the tracking methods that people claim work. The email protocol allows email messages to actually include a request for delivery receipt and/or read receipt. A delivery receipt is an email message that is automatically sent by the recipient's email program when the email arrives. A read receipt is an email message automatically sent by the recipient's email program when the email is opened. Most email programs no longer respond to either of those things, and they ignore them both completely. You'll get no notification, even if you ask for one. At best, the program might ask the recipient whether to send the receipt. Most recipients, of course, say no. The reason, as you might have guessed, is spam. Spammers try to use these receipts to validate that they're sending to a valid email address. And as a result, if it turns out to be valid, they'll send even more spam. No one wants that, so the features are disabled by default. The other approach are tracking images, sometimes referred to as bugs or tracking bugs. Images can be included in HTML or rich text email messages, of which most email is these days. Those images can be included with the message, or they can be fetched from a location on the internet to be displayed. It's the latter one that we care about. A good example is my newsletter. It includes at least two images, a logo at the top and my signature at the bottom. These images themselves are not in the email. When you open an email with those images, and if you have image display enabled, then your email program fetches them. It requests them from my web server, an action that my web server can log. Now, the request for an image can even be tailored to the specific email address that was sent to. For example, here's a link to an image. Happens to be the current Ask Leo logo that you'll find at the top of my newsletter. If it's clicked on, or if it's used in an email to display an image, I can tell that the image has been fetched. This might allow me to say, 10,000 people fetched this image. I can't tell which people, I just know that 10,000 did. On the other hand, this version of the link, which includes additional information, tells me more. It displays the same image, but the request includes that additional information that tells me that Leo at askleo.com actually requested the image. Doesn't have to be quite as blatant or as obvious as an email address, any kind of encoded information. In some cases, even the name of the image being fetched can be unique to each recipient. Now, it sounds like a perfect tracking mechanism to determine whether a specific recipient has opened an email. So, yep, spammers started using it. If the image was fetched, the spammer knew that they had reached a real person who looked at it, and then thus they should send them more spam. And that, in turn, is why email programs no longer display images by default. If image display is disabled, the entire approach to tracking via image references fails. Now, as I said, I get pushback from individuals or services who provide open and delivery tracking services, telling me that their service is special and it works. The techniques they use fall into two buckets. Image open tracking, like I just described, that may work for many recipients, but it cannot be relied upon to work for every recipient. Even if only one recipient refuses to display images, it invalidates the claim. The other approach is actually not email. One technique is to move the message delivery away from the email infrastructure to a private message delivery tool. Usually, this forces the recipient to visit a specific web page to get the message. This doesn't track how many people got or opened the email. It only tracks the number of people who were willing to take that extra step to get the message. Now, most companies offering to track email usage use image references. Since many people enable image display for emails from people they know and trust, it can still kind of sort of work. However, if an image is referenced, then the email was displayed. Is that success? Not really. Just because it was displayed on someone's screen doesn't mean that it was read. They could have just been scrolling through quickly looking for something else, for example. If an image was not referenced, then the email may have been lost, ignored, or routed to a spam filter. Or it might have been read with the image display turned off. As I said, the technique is simply not 100% reliable. The most common alternative boils down to using, say, a private messaging system. The technique works like this. You place your message on an online service, perhaps your own web server, and then email a link to the message instead of the message itself. In order to read your message, the recipient must click on the link and visit the web server holding the message. That visit can be logged. An exchange server is another kind of private messaging system. People on an exchange server-based system sending to others on that same system, for instance, at a business, can get reliable notifications that the email has been sent, read, or opened. But it only works if both sender and receiver are using the same email system to begin with. If the email message can simply be read on its own without requiring external resources just by showing up in someone's inbox, then nope. There is no way to know with 100% certainty whether or not the message was delivered, opened, read, or ignored completely. Now, I use open tracking on my newsletter. You're probably wondering why I do that if it's so unreliable. For example, I don't know with 100% certainty whether you have opened my newsletter. I don't. What I care about is trends, and I don't need 100% open tracking for that. If this week's newsletter shows that 50% of my subscribers opened the newsletter, meaning that my logo or my signature was displayed, and next week that number drops to 25%, I care about that. I care about that a lot. Now, to be clear, if it shows that 50% of my recipients opened my newsletters, it does not mean that exactly 50% did so. Some may have opened the newsletter with images disabled, and thus were not tracked. 50% means that at least 50% of my recipients opened the newsletter, and probably more that were untracked. Open rates are great for this kind of trend analysis. Almost every newsletter you receive has some form of it enabled. Again, we're not looking at you specifically. We're looking at how our subscribers, as a group, are reacting to what we provide. A sudden drop in open rates can mean many things, ranging from uninteresting content to spam filters that have suddenly decided that what we're sending out is spam. What it means is that email publishers need to pay attention and address the issue. Hopefully, we learn what you find most engaging and what is more likely to be delivered in your inbox instead of your spam folder. And that leads to better newsletters, well, for everyone. Bottom line here is that if you need to know that a specific email has been opened or read, email tracking is not the solution. You need to consider alternatives. If you care about trends, then these techniques are a fine approach, particularly if you're sending to an audience that more or less inherently trusts you and is likely to display the images you include in your email. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/18771. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.